So, as we talked about on last Friday, we talked about breaking down our partner's posture, and then as they're returning, as their posture is returning, we set up a sweep, whether it be scissor sweep or scissor sweep variation. Remember, the way that I show things may be different than the way someone else shows things, and I've had a really good fortune of training with a lot of different instructors. And the funny thing that I have noticed in my journey to black belt, I trained under three different instructors. Since attaining a black belt, I've trained with two different instructors. So I've seen people do the same thing very different ways. And it's cool. And to me, it's really interesting that you can get to the same outcome with just a slight tweak in detail, and it changes the way that you do it. Now, it doesn't necessarily make one way better than the other, but it's cool to see that there's a lot of different ways to do things and still come to the same result. So I get back from my tangent here. So we talked about on Friday the scissor sweep and scissor sweep variation. So immediately, anytime someone's in my guard here, I want to break my partner's posture down. So we're just going to do the simple guard or simple posture break that we've been doing for the last couple of days. I'm going to sit up. I'm going to cut my hands behind my partner's head here. I'm going to lift up ever so slightly, and then I'm going to pull my partner forward here, breaking down their posture. From here, my partner is going to start pushing away. If you guys remember, I choose one sleeve. I come down, one hand finds the sleeve by the wrist here. As she's posturing her way up, as I feel her start to get away, I'm dropping my hand and grabbing a hold of the lapel here. From here, I'm going to open up my guard, hip escape, bringing my knee up across the center here. Remember, we wanted to make sure we have a nice bandolier, and I'm not going to push into the wall, but we're going to scoot in a second here. So my foot is hooking on her hip. My knee is up by her shoulder here. This is an important detail. We don't want to be down like this, because all it's going to take is my partner to sprawl, and she just circles. Now she can circle any way she wants, and that's just not going to be good for me. So I want to make sure that when I have my leg up here, it's not lazy. I'm kind of pushing into her a little bit, so that it's hard for her to smash my leg down. From here, I then go, I'm not gonna launch it. From here, I'm gonna go for my scissor sweep. Now, if you guys remember, we talked about three different ways of doing this. Just doing the regular scissor sweep. Scissor sweep, the first way of doing it is just basically scissoring my legs. This works, this is especially good if my partner is lighter than I am or hasn't settled yet. Meaning I can just kind of pull their legs out. So I'm kicking this leg down and I'm driving this foot across, which causes my scissoring action. Option.
You should turn anyway. So people
can see better anyway. Thank you. Excuse me. No, you're good. Thank you. So from here, we go for our first way of doing the scissor sweep. We just scissor our legs, and that causes our partner to fall over. Our second option is when my partner has settled their hips a little bit here, but I still have somewhat control, meaning I can actually pull them forward. And so this one, what I'm doing, the second way of doing this is I'm just pulling them forward enough to get their center of gravity out from underneath their hips. If it's underneath their hips and I just try to scissor here, I'm not gonna have very good results. But if I am able to pull my partner forward a little bit here, now that her center of gravity is out in front of her, it's gonna be a lot easier for me to scissor my legs and get my sweep. And then if you guys remember our last variation or our last way of doing just a regular scissor sweep here is if my partner is sitting heavy, and it's usually, this one is the one that we will do when someone is heavier than us. Because usually option number two is where I can pull someone forward and just kind of scissor through. Usually you can do that with someone your size or smaller. But now when it comes time to the big person where it's just like you can't really budge them much anywhere at all, and like trying to pull them forward is really difficult. This is the one where I have to scoot and pull forward just a hair here. And now from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to arch my back and I'm going to look up over my shoulders. At the same time, I'm going to scissor my legs. So from here, I'm arching my back and I'm going to look over my shoulder as I scissor my legs. And I can usually get someone a lot larger than I am with that sweep. What time is it?
Oh, I can't see either. is 5 for 5.
Perfect. So that was the first. So that was what we did on Friday, and we'll review. This Friday, I want to review everything we've done to this point, which I think is what we're going to spend the majority of our time with on this Friday. But with that being said, now we're going to move forward with more new stuff today. So I have my partner in my close guard. Once again, we're going to break our partner down. Now, this time we break our partner down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with a good grip on her lapel. And so when I feed, we're going to be doing a front cross choke and a loop choke, and I want to keep it in that same vein that we've been working on this whole week, where we've had our partner nice and close to us, where we've broken them down and their head is resting on our chest. So what I'm going to do is when I do this, I want to sit up and I'm going to feed my first grip is my most important grip, especially for my front cross choke. And I tell this to my students often. The front cross choke is one of the most fundamental chokes in jiu-jitsu, and is also one of the hardest to hit live. And the reasoning is because there's a lot of variables that are involved with it, and you need everything to be almost just perfect. And once you get that just perfect, hitting the choke is actually relatively easy when everything is set up just perfect. And that's when it becomes difficult, is getting that just perfect way of doing it. So from here, this time when I sit up, I'm going to go across my body and feed the lapel through. So I'm going to sit up here and I'm going to go across the body, feed the lapel nice and deep. If I need to, I can use my free hand, but I'm going to sit up. I'm going to feed my hand through nice and deep here. So when you do this, where I want to go is I want my hand to go and I want to try to grab with my fingers her label on the inside of her gi here. If you guys can see this. Her label is right here, this red material. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit up and I'm going to feed my hand through. Now, if you're having a hard time and for whatever reason, if their lapel is kind of taut here and it's difficult to feed your hand through, all I got to do is open up the lapel, open up here, and now I can feed it nice and deep. Remember, I need my hand to go through. I need to be hurt. My fingertips need to be wrapped around the label here. So I come through, I sit up. Come through. I have a hand, strong hand full of label, and now I'm going to try to pull my partner forward. But she's gonna post on my hips and pull herself away here. So now this is difficult. This becomes the kind of the pulling match. And what can happen is I want to mess up my partner a little bit to make it easier for me to pull them forward. If you remember yesterday, we talked about using the legs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my free hand here. I'm going to let go of the lapel. I'm going to grab the outside of her elbow here. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop her elbow out. And at the same time, or right after I pop her elbow out, I'm going to pull her forward with my legs here. And this is our first, this is where we want to get to here, where my hand is down close to my chest here. And my other hand is on her elbow. This is going to make it actually easier because now I can actually, basically I'm going to scoop my hip out to the side because this gives me a little bit more space. So I open up, I scoop my hip out to the side. Now it actually gives me a little bit better angle for me to bring my hand across. I'm going to grab a hold of her. We're going to do this from a different angle in a moment. I'm going to grab a hold of the top of her shoulder here. Now from here, she's going to posture away again. As she's posturing her away, I loop my arm over. My elbows then come together here. From right here, I'm pulling forward, and I'm going to open up my hands. And I'll show you guys what it looks like without her in my hands in a second here. But I'm going to open up my hands, and I get my tap. And this is a very, like I said, this is a very fundamental choke, but there's a lot of things that people do that make it incorrect and make it easier to defend. And you may have some success when you're doing this is going like this, but the problem is that this is very easy to block. If I start flaring my elbows out, all Chelsea has to do is start pushing down on my elbows and all of a sudden the choke starts to go away. What I want to do with my hands, and this is what I said I was going to do a second ago, is I'm doing this motion. So basically I'm driving, my wrist bones into her carotid artery. And that's what's causing the choke to happen. But once again, this needs to be, my hand needs to be very, very deep. That first grip is the most important grip. The deeper, the better. If I can grab the label, that's awesome. If I can go deeper than that, even better. The farther around the neck I can get, the more success I'm going to have with this choke. This is a very, This is a very tight choke once you actually set it in place. But like I said, there's a lot of small details that make it a very difficult thing to do. So let's change the angle a little bit here. Let's go on this side. And are we in the middle? I can't see.
Yes.
Okay. So from here, I'm going to take my free, I'm going to go across the body. So I sit up, I go across the body, and I feed my hand through. If I need to, I can open her lapel up and feed the hand through. From here, I'm going to start pulling her forward. She's going to posture back away, not allow me to do this. And I want this tension here because when I bring my legs into the fight, I'm going to have a lot more success than if she's kind of loose here. I actually want her really pushing hard because once I pop this elbow out and pull her forward, it actually makes it harder for her to push away. There's a little change in direction, and I pop my partner forward. From here, I'm now going to hip escape. So my free hip, I'm going to go to my left side, which is the free side here. I'm going to hip escape out just a little bit. This helps me change the angle. And now when I come across here, I can grab a hold of her shoulder. If you guys notice, my guard is not open anymore, and it's totally fine at this point. I'm just keeping my legs down. When she starts to sit up, I loop my arm around her head and then bring my hands in and bring my wrists back together. Last part, I'm going to close my guard up, and I'm going to pull her forward. I'm going to bring my elbows to my abdomen, and now I'm going to open up my wrists. This is a very tight choke if it's deep enough. The problem is that when students first try this, and I'm definitely as guilty as this as the next person, is we grab a short, shallow grip, meaning I'm grabbing by the collarbone here, and then I try to get the choke, and that's not going to work anywhere near as well. You may be able to get it, but the deeper that hand is, now when I do this, I'm cutting down that space. I'm obviously, my hands are not moving because I'm grabbing a hold of material here. But what this does is it causes when I'm doing this motion, it causes my wrist to push into the neck, which then gets your partner to tap. So, like I said, a lot of small details in this, but it's a really great choke. And it's one of those chokes that you can use to set up other attacks. So let's get Chelsea to give it a shot here and see how she does with it. So my hands are on the hips. She feeds through that deep grip there. She's pulling me forward.
Go ahead.
So from here, she takes her hand, grabs the outside of my elbow. She's going to pop my elbow out at the same time. She's going to use her legs and pull me forward. Yeah, perfect. Good. Now from right here, I have to start to recover. So she's going to start to hip escape out to the side a little bit. She's going to take her hand and she's going to grab a hold of my shoulder. Not there, next to my ear. There you go. Good. So when you're grabbing the shoulder next to the ear. You're not grabbing down by the arm here. From here, as I start to posture up, she's going to loop her arm over my head. Perfect. Close up your guard again. Good. Now from here, elbows go down. Open up your hand. Good. So we want to make sure when you do this, you're grabbing right by the ear, pulling the elbows in, and then open up your hands. Let's do that one more time. So one more time from here, she opens up, sits up, grabs a hold, starts pulling me forward. I'm fighting her. She grabs a hold of the outside of my elbow, pops me forward. Very nice. Good. Scoot out to the side. I'm starting to push away. She wants to grab a hold of my shoulder. Now from here, I'm going to posture up. She's going to loop her arm. Very good. Coming in, squaring back up. Go ahead, close it. Finish it. Perfect. Awesome. And that's how you finish that. So, like I said, there's a lot of small details involved in that choke. But if you start with a deep grip with your first hand, you're already halfway there, at the very minimum halfway there. So we're going to go over our next choke. Next choke is called loop choke. And loop choke, the way we're going to work this loop choke is we're going to originally go for my, I'm going to go for my original front cross choke. So I'm gonna sit up and I'm gonna try to get my hand in deep. What's gonna happen is Chelsea's gonna realize that I'm trying to get that deep grip with my hand, and she's gonna start pushing me down, so it's harder for me to get. She's gonna start pushing down, meaning her hands are gonna float from my hips up to my abdomen a little more. And what that does is when I sit up here, now all of a sudden she starts to limit my range of motion. If her hands are on my hips here, I can still sit up. She can keep her posture and she can still push away, but she's pushing on my hips, not on my abdomen. So when she's pushing on my abdomen, it messes up my ability to sit up all the way, which in turn is going to make it more difficult for me to get my deep grip here. So what I'm going to do is as I sit up, I come up. No, keep your hands here. I'm going to sit up. I grab a hold of the lapel, and I'm starting to pull myself up from right here. Now her hands are going to sneak to my abdomen. She's going to start pushing. If you guys notice, my hand is not all the way deep anymore. I'm about even with her. My choking hand is now about even with her collarbone. So I can't quite pull her forward. I can't quite get that that distance I need, meaning deep enough for that front cross choke. So I'm going to do the same setup, but now I'm going to do it with a shorter grip. So I have to change the quality of change the type of choke that I actually go for here. So from here, I'm still finding the elbow again, and now I'm going to use my legs and pull her forward. Here, here. So I'm popping the elbow out and pulling my partner's head forward. So from here, she's going to start to posture up. This time, my hand is going to come over her head. Go ahead, keep posturing. I'm going to go over her head. I'm going to lift my elbow and drive my hand through. Now she postures up, and I'm extending my legs away. It's kind of like a... It is a loop choke. It's not anything else. It's a loop choke. So as she's posturing up, I'm pushing my hands in like this. I'm basically turning this elbow up, and I'm swimming this hand through. So we're going to do it again. From here, I sit up. She starts to float. I'm trying to get deeper grip. She pushes me back down. I can't get that deep grip anymore, so I have to go with the shallow one. So from here, I'm going to pull my partner forward so my hand comes to the outside of the elbow here. I'm popping it out and pulling my partner forward with my legs here. Once the hand is out, I immediately bring my hand over the top of her head. I'm assuming that she's going to start trying to pull herself away. As she's pulling herself away, my free hand loops underneath my rib, underneath my forearm, and now I'm just going to go ahead. I sit up, I'm going to extend, and I get my choke. It's a very tight choke. The reason being is because her neck is 100% exposed. As she's starting to try to posture away, her neck is open, which makes the choke that much easier to get. This is a great choke, especially on beginners, because they don't understand the mechanics of the choke. As you get up higher up in level, this starts to become a lot less effective. However, you can use it for setups for other things. Everything, it's good to be, as I kind of went on a rant about this last week, it's good to be well-versed in the fundamentals, because you can use your fundamentals to set up your more advanced game. And people don't feel threatened by fundamentals, especially when you get higher up in level. They're like, oh, I know that. Oh, I know that. Oh, I know that. I know what they're doing. And so there tends to be a little a lull in the in your partner's ability to kind of not necessarily foresee what you're doing, but they tend to be a little bit more relaxed. Oh, I got that covered. I know what my defense is for that. And as you start to kind of progress, your game progresses into more advanced moves. As you're setting up your attacks, you're going to have more success with that, because you're going to find that those people, everybody's like, oh yeah, you're just trying to do the front cross choke, and oh, okay, oh, he switches to the loop choke. That's a little different. So that's just a little idea, some thoughts on strategy for you. So once again, from right here, my hands are on Chelsea's hips. Chelsea's going to sit up. She grabs a hold of my lapel. She starts trying to feed her hand in deeper, but I walk my hands up, and I'm pushing her away here. So now she's got a grip about by my collarbone here. Her free hand grabs a hold of my elbow, and now once again, she pops and pulls. Good, nice. From right here, her free hand then pops over the top of my head. Now you're going to loop your hand underneath this arm. Yep. So as I'm pushing away, you're going to open up.
Oh, I just let you do it?
You're going to push your hands away.
Oh, okay.
There it is.
Perfect. That's cool.
So the idea being is your hand is underneath. You're actually using your backhand to push the head down as you pull your elbow up. So I'm pushing through, pulling the elbow up. So one more time here. Good. There it is. Good. Very nice. Excellent. Very good. So, these are two really great chokes that work really well together. If you can kind of float your attacks, or you have more options, more setups from the same position, your attacks, you're going to have a lot more and more success with your attacks. The reason being is because you're able to mask your game. You're able to add multiple attacks into one position and one way of doing things, and that makes you very versatile and extremely dangerous. Thank you guys very much. That's it for today. Reminder, we're here Monday through Thursday Pacific time, 5 o'clock to about 5:30, depending on how long this takes. On Friday, we're going to be here from 2 Pacific Standard Time to about 2:30 or so, maybe a little later, maybe a little earlier, not sure yet. We'll see how things go. You guys, anybody that watches this, if this is during the quarantine time, anyone anywhere is welcome to join in on our chat, is welcome to open up a camera, and I'd be happy to give you my 2 cents worth on that, on what you're doing, how you can improve your position, or just anything in general. I'd be happy to help with. Thank you guys so much for coming today. Remember, during this time, take care of yourself, take care of others. Don't just look at your little world. Remember that we're all a part of a community here. So thank you guys very much.
Just so you guys know, all of our videos are available. If you can't make it to the live stream, you guys can watch them afterwards. And you guys can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. We are at Heart and Soul BJJ. The link is actually in the description, as well as the Discord channel. We have 9 spots available every day for anybody who wants to open up their camera, for Chris to let you guys know, or to give you, like, so it's 2 cents worth. Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we have a yoga class at noon that I teach, and we are just really happy to have you here. Please like and subscribe the channel and the video. It really helps support, since, like we said, we're doing this for free, so it really does give us, it's the best way to support us. Awesome. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you guys very much. You guys have a great rest of your day. Let's call it.